The 1980s were all about the mall. I think it was not that it was just the right place to establish Wonder Woman. I think it was the perfect portrait of America at that height.
We wanted to create something that was fun and thrilling and really to capture the 80s in its best.
Boom, catching. The mall is a portrait of what our world very much felt like. It was bright, it was colorful, it was shiny, but it was also the status quo. It was like a portrait of the new normal. This is life. You eat whatever you want, you do whatever you want, food courts, opulence, buy things, shopping bags. And you're also seeing Wonder Woman at the top of her game coming in and saving the day in the midst of that setting. It was a very interesting thing to think about those visuals as they juxtaposed from each other.
When we scouted the landmark mall in Virginia, we were thrilled of its existence to find an empty mall of the period that still was workable. You know, the escalators worked, the elevators worked, the bathrooms worked. We were all sort of really ecstatic that such a thing existed.
Making the mall was one of the more impressive things I've ever seen my production designer do, and she's pretty impressive. We chose the biggest space in the entire mall for a pretty big set piece. So it meant that we had to recreate a pretty substantial part of the mall.
I've designed for this movie like 65 stores to fill and create and design and find the signage and find the light and find the item. You need to make a proper research before being able to full of this 65 shop.
She brought it back to life in such a way that it was three full stories of stores stocked completely. And so you could actually walk around this mall and walk into the record store and find records from the 80s. There was something magical about that mall that when you would walk into it, there were days I didn't want to leave because it felt like you were back in time and you could remember this much more naive feeling about how life was.
From the start, our whole ethos and pitch on this was that we wanted to actually do as much as we can real wire work. We've done more wire work on this movie than I've ever done on any other movie.
I don't think we need to go reaching on her. She's gonna stand up into it, but she's also gonna stand up into it and start running.
Historically, wire rigs would pull you over something and land you. What these wire rigs involved was multiple different points of movement. We had a crew in Washington, D.C. doing this rigging for the longest time.
Normally what stunts like this would be shot on a soundstage. So on a soundstage you'd end up with like a big grid that you could actually rig from. We're in a mall, so we were speculating what was in the roof until we got here. So we've had to cut into the columns and then strap into them. Before they were kind of using all the CG takeoffs and CG landings. Everything here we're doing is for real. So you'll see her physically fly through the mall, you'll see her physically land, you'll see her run. They're all done for real.
The mall had different levels and it gives us a great opportunity for a fantastic action sequence of Wonder Woman with the lasso.
The entire sequence is all human bodies doing exactly what you're seeing. And so it was exhausting and laborious, but it was incredible even to like sit and watch on the day, these bodies flying around and these incredible acrobatic stunts and gals flipping over things and landing.
You guys are amazing.
I miss the spectacles of the films that were pretty common in the 80s, early 90s, where you were seeing real stunts on screen and really incredible things. So as difficult as it was going to be to pull off, from the start, we really decided to make a grand spectacle again and bring it onto screen. And now embrace all of this technology that was possible.